Anyway, I'm Efrain, and I'm ready for this lesson. Everybody can say hello there. I'm very happy to have you here, and yeah. Qué bueno que todos están aquí. Estoy muy alegre, por favor, escríbanos cada uno de ustedes un saludo. Pueden decir algo. Me pueden escuchar bien. Me pueden ver bien. Pueden ver mi bonita cámara. Mi bonita cámara. Mi bonita máscara.
¿Qué dijo?
¿Qué dijo? Ok, ya estoy viendo ahí algunos comentarios. Y bueno, hoy tenemos un tema básico. Today we're talking about, how do you call this?
Possessive adjectives?
No, I mean, yeah, of course we're talking about possessive adjectives. But this is like a core lesson. How can I say it? Yeah. So very, very important. And we are actually going to talk about possessive things. These
possessive
2 weeks.
Things.
Okay, it's because I can't
possessive
say.
Adjectives.
No,
so.
No. I mean, the next lesson is going to be about something related.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, so that's the idea.
Pronouns.
Yeah, no, don't tell them.
Ah, but
no,
they will know at the end.
Yeah, but at the end.
Why don't we say hi to our viewers? So, tenemos a. Tenemos a. We have a lot. Lia, ¿cómo estás, Lia? ¿Cómo
Hola.
Estás? A ti, ya. Yeah. De parte de Frank, ¿cuál es tu nombre de luchador?
El matador.
El matador Efraín. Very good. So tenemos a Lia. Hola Lia, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estás? Tenemos a
Hola,
Cody.
Lia.
Hola Cody.
Cody.
Easy the Great. Hola amigos. Hola Easy the Great. John Lada Nalacorn. Buenos días. Muy buenos días. Hey. Harold Waters. ¿Cómo estamos, Harold? CM Lady. Y el padrino. Tenemos a Anne. Dice, hola, my dears, hola, Ann.
Gracias por estar, Ann, gracias, CM Lady.
Perfecto,
gracias.
Tenemos a Rio Riley, mi luchador. Hola, príncipes, ¿cómo están? Yo muy bien, ¿y tú, Rio, qué tal? ¿Cómo estamos?
Mi príncipe, ¿cómo estás?
Perfecto, tenemos a Jeff, Nikeel Games, hi.
Jeff,
hi, hola.
Nikeel.
Ori Plays, hola, ¿qué tal? Tenemos a Antonio Reyes, hola, muchas gracias por estar aquí. Mujil, Jonathan Caballero, John Song, muchísimas gracias a todos. Tenemos a muchísimos, tenemos a Mila, tenemos a Pau.
Mila, ¿cómo estás?
Muchas gracias por estar aquí. Muchísimas gracias. Jennifer Hunt, después de mucho tiempo tenemos a
Jennifer
Hunt.
En México diríamos, qué milagro.
Qué
What
milagro.
Exactly. Qué milagro.
Excelente. Vamos a ver ahora si tenemos algo aquí en Facebook. Y
okay,
en Facebook tenemos, claro que sí. Como siempre, tenemos a Mayri Flores. Muchas gracias por estar con nosotros, Mayri Flores.
Mayri.
Tenemos a Leyona Torres. Hola, chicos, ¿qué tal? Muy bien, ¿y tú? Perfecto. Juan Pancho.
Juan.
I love that name. So, it's hola, hoy quiero aprender.
Hola.
Perfecto. Tenemos a Niket Masram. Hola,
hola,
hermanos.
Hola.
Hola.
Gracias.
Daniel Bilodeau. Hola, de Quebec. Oh, my God, Quebec. I love it, me encanta. Ok, pues bienvenido
Muchas
a la lección.
Gracias a todos.
Let's get started, vamos a empezar con esto, chicos. Y
Where's Janet? Wait,
seriously, where's Janet?
Oh,
what's
here.
His hand?
That's her hand.
Her hand, ok, very good. That,
so, yeah, come and visit us. We will.
You can have your hand here displayed in
the
live stream.
You. We receive you. You send us a message.
Let's now start with the possessive adjectives, guys. So, let's get started.
Let's go.
But first.
Okay, first
let me
of
take
all.
A selfie.
that's a song. Okay.
Yeah.
Nice joke. Okay. Get your free lifetime account at SpanishBoot101.com. Maybe you're wondering where to start learning. Okay, so this is a nice place to start.
That's correct.
And we have free PDF cheat sheets where you can learn tons and tons of vocabulary. Mm-hmm. New vocabulary every day, like for time, for sports, for social media, for time.
Traveling.
For traveling. I said time already. For relationships, for love. For anything.
Remember getting
anything.
A Mexican husband. How to get a Mexican husband as well.
Well, that's a joke, but
we're
you
working,
can get tons.
We're working on it.
Working on it. Yeah, because Wilson talked to me last time. One of one of the people that works with us.
And he was like, asking me,
I'm looking for that one. Am I losing something? But that's a joke. How to get a close one?
That's a joke.
Okay, yeah. So it's just one click away, and you just need to click down there in the description of YouTube, and it is up there in Facebook. Just one click away. Get now your free lifetime account. Free lifetime account. At SpanishBot101.com.
So the first question here is, what is a possessive adjective? Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know. Let's find out. The present of the indicative expresses actions. They are used with a noun, in order to show what someone or something possesses. Okay? So this is clue. The indicative express actions. Okay, they're used with a noun and they show what someone or something possesses. Okay? Now, in English, a possessive adjective is one of these words. So you may be familiar with my, your, his, her, its, our, or their.
Uh-huh.
We have the similar thing in Spanish.
It's very similar.
That's what we call a possessive adjective.
Sí, claro.
Very good. Muy bien. Perfecto. And we use it with nouns.
Uh-huh.
Very good. So let's see. What are the possessive adjectives that we have here?
Well, yeah, for English you just have one. We have, well, like two. In this case,
well,
for the
more,
first
right?
one.
Because you have for, my, ah, for the first
for
one.
For the first one. One, because for no, for our, we have four forms. Okay, yeah, let's go. For example, me, for feminine me, mis, y mis. So pay close attention to this. Tú. For plural masculine, tus and tus. Okay, let's go. To mean you. But look at this. This is just for the informal one. When you're talking about tú.
Exactly. So be careful because this is just for informal.
Yeah.
So you use tú only for the informal version. Good.
Uh-huh.
Now, we also have in English, you have her or his or even your for usted. But in Spanish, we have much more ways.
Mm-hmm.
So we have su for masculine. Feminine su as well. Then we have plural masculine sus and feminine sus. In the case of your for usted is the same. So sus and sus. Take this into account, guys, because this might be very easy, but at the quiz at the end you might struggle with this. So pay close attention.
You made me remind that song that is mi pan su. It is a song.
Something like that. Okay, so that we have now the singular and the plural form of our and stop singing that.
Okay,
song.
Yeah, sorry.
So,
I've got to show you that at the end of
you're
this.
You're going to stick that song in my head.
It's really sticky.
So, our and their. In that case, in our and their, we have nuestro for singular, nuestra for feminine, for plural we have nuestros and nuestras. But it is strange because in English we have just our. But in Spanish we have nuestro, nuestra, nuestras and nuestras.
Four.
So be careful with this, okay? Now for there, it's easier because we just have the singular form su and the plural form sus.
Yep.
And that's it.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. So these are the possessive adjectives. Esos son todos los que tenemos.
Yeah, you just need to memorize them. They are not very difficult to learn. And if they are not clear yet, we have some examples.
Of course.
So we are just starting the lesson.
Of course. Now let's see some side notes. So the two words tú and tú, so as you can see, they sound different. However, tú, with an accent there, okay, with a written accent, is a subject pronoun. Meaning you.
Mm-hmm.
And tú without the accent is your. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Tú without the written accent is a possessive adjective.
Yeah.
So the only difference is not when you speak, but rather when you write.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, tú with an accent is the subject, tú without the accent is the possessive adjective.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? They are pronounced the same. Tú and tú.
Yeah.
Very good. Now, su and tú both mean your. The difference between them is a formality the speaker wishes to convey. That is, su is going to be used for formality. That's for usted.
Mm-hmm.
And tú is for an informal setting. That is for tú.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty easy, right?
Mm-hmm.
Very good.
Yeah.
Now let's see some examples.
Yeah, well, Leah says, No, los acentos.
No, no los acentos. No, this is very easy. Yeah. This is super, super,
just,
super easy.
Just remember to use an accent when you're talking about the pronoun. Mm-hmm. And you don't need an accent when you need the to talk about the for the possessive adjective.
That's correct.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Just like that.
Very good. Now let's see some examples with possessive adjectives. The first one.
¿Dónde están tus primos? ¿Dónde están tus primos? Where are your cousins? And then, esta es mi guitarra favorita. Esta es mi guitarra favorita. So actually, this is my favorite model. Fender Telecaster.
So you just want to show off that you know about guitars?
No, this is my favorite one, actually.
Do you have one?
No, I have one, but it is not this model.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, let's go.
So if you want to make a gift to Efrain, now you know what you can give him.
Even a picture.
Even just a picture, like.
It doesn't matter.
Okay, so another example could be.
Mis amigos perdieron sus pasaportes. Mis amigos perdieron sus pasaportes. My friends lost their passports. Okay, so pay attention to this. The possessive adjective.
You see, it is difficult to pronounce.
The possessive adjective agrees with the noun.
Yeah.
Not with the subject.
We will see this later, but be careful with this. Sus pasaportes.
Sus pas. The next one. Esta es nuestra casa. Mm-hmm. Esta es nuestra casa, singular and feminine. This is our house.
Very good. Or,
Armando dice que sus papás están en la ciudad. Armando dice que sus papás están en la ciudad. Armando says that his parents are in town. Hey, I love my t-shirt, by the way.
The pizza?
Pizza. Pizza rules.
Very good. Okay, now let's give you some tips. Tip number one for the possessive adjectives. Now, bear this in mind, guys. Take your pen and your notebook because these might be very, very, very useful. If you don't have one, well, take your phone and then you can write there. Yep. Okay, so now, let's see. Note that possessive adjectives agree with what they describe, not with the person who owns that thing.
Yeah.
Why? Because the verbs agree with the subject, with the person, because I say, yo como, tú comes, él come, nosotros comemos.
Okay.
So the verb agrees with the subject, but in this case, the possessive adjective does not agree with the subject, but rather with the object or with the thing.
Yeah, that's the clue. I mean, nailed it.
Of course, that's, I nailed it. So for example, we have, estos son mis libros.
Yep.
Mis libros. So mis is referring to the books because it is plural. Mm-hmm. You say libros. That's why these are my books. These are my books.
Yeah.
Or even we have the next one, and that's Carlos perdió sus bolígrafos. Poor Carlos. Pobre Carlitos. Carlos perdió sus bolígrafos. So even though Carlos is singular, you use sus. Why? Because once again, this has to do with the object, the possession, not with the subject. That's why you use sus. Yeah. Very good. Very easy, right?
Very easy.
Super easy. Shall we go to the quiz right now? No?
Yeah, I think.
No, let's continue.
Okay, the next example. Esta es su mochila. Esta es su mochila. This is his or her backpack. Okay, so now it's your turn.
Okay, guys, so we just want to remind you very quickly that you can get your free lifetime account. And apart from that, we have a special deal today, only today. Well, not only today,
but only today.
Especially, I want to say this only today for you guys. If you click down below right now, in the next 15 seconds, we will give all our free PDF cheat sheets for you guys, where you can learn 1,000 of words.
Awesome!
Vocabulary, very useful for your daily routines, your daily life. So go and get it right now at SpanishPod101.com and also get your free lifetime account.
Take a break. Yeah.
Very good, guys. So now let's continue with the tip number two. Once again, if you haven't take out your pen and your notebook, this is the moment where you should do it.
Yeah.
Because this tip will blow your mind.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Mi pan.
As you can see, su and sus are the singular and plural form for meaning his, her, it's, your, or their. So we just have two.
Mm-hmm.
Su and sus, and this means his, her, it's, your, or their.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes it could be confusing, right? Because I can say, este es su libro.
Okay.
Am I meaning his, her, it's,
their,
your, there?
Oh yeah, you're in the formal.
In the formal form or
for
there?
Death.
Which one am I meaning? So we have a tip for you.
Man.
It can be confusing, of course, as we have said.
Yeah, all the time.
And sometimes it's necessary to clarify who possesses the object. ¿Quién posee ese objeto?
Yeah.
For this, you can use an equivalent in Spanish. And for that is of him.
Yeah.
We say of him.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see how this works.
Yeah.
Entonces, por ejemplo, tenemos su or sus, but we can say instead of su or sus, we can say
de él.
De él.
De él.
And that's of him.
Yeah.
Or another way, his.
His.
His. Or we have su or sus or
de ella. De ella.
Of her.
Uh-huh.
Or only her.
Yep.
And we have su and sus for
de usted. De usted. Of you.
Of you. Formal. Mm-hmm. Formal, yep. Right? Very good. Or even we have the ellos, su or sus, and then we have of them, the ellos. But remember that in Spanish we also have ellas, which is for the feminine version, su and sus, and we have the ellas.
The ellas.
Uh-huh. Now we have su and sus for the ustedes, you formal, like you all, you all. Remember that in at least in Latin American Spanish we don't truly use vosotros, so we stick with ustedes for you all. So this is the form that we use for meaning plural second person, like you all. Okay.
Yeah.
For example, let's see some examples.
Let's
to clarify
see some
this.
Examples. Okay. Estas son las cosas de ella. Estas son las cosas de ella.
Yeah.
These are her things. Bien. Estoy con los primos de ellos. Estoy con los primos de ellos. I'm with their cousins.
Bien.
Okay. So, vamos a volver a tomar este tema en el siguiente live. Because this is not like good enough. And we are going to talk about that in the
this
next
is not
lesson.
Enough. This is not enough.
But
because we need to reinforce this. However, bear this in mind that if you want to avoid confusion, you just use the plus the person.
Yep.
That's the thing. So, estas son las cosas de ella. Sometimes people say, estas son sus cosas, but since it is not clarified enough, you need to say of who.
Yep.
So, that's why they add de ella, de él, and so on and so forth.
Yep.
So, or for example, estoy con los primos de ellos. So sometimes people can say
estoy con
well está or está con sus primos
con sus
but of who like de ellos de ellas like
de tu amigo
de quién. Very good, so that's where you need to clarify it. Very good, guys. So or
estos son los boletos de ustedes. Estos son los boletos de ustedes. So, plural for you.
Plural. So, imagine, it would be confusing if you say, estos son sus boletos. It would be like, what are you talking about? Of her?
Of usted.
Of usted.
Yeah, like, son sus boletos.
Of,
de
of
usted.
Him. Exactly.
De él,
Of who?
Yeah.
So, de ustedes.
Mm-hmm.
So, you see, we will explain this much better in the next topic, which is the pronouns. Now, you will see this later, okay? So, now the tip number 3, once again.
And can you read some comments, man?
Let me read some
please.
Comments, of course, of course. I miss Janet here so much in the comments, don't you?
Janet, come
she's
on.
She's always telling things such as
say something.
Diego is very handsome or stuff like that. And I don't. Okay, so are our beautiful teachers offering to be the Mexican husbands we will learn how to get? What do you believe, Tejo?
Yeah, it is not very difficult to get one.
Later we should do a video on how to conquer us so they know how to do it.
Yeah, it will be very, I mean, like, very useful and very
super super useful. So
you will learn a lot of Spanish.
CM Lady says accents are easy once you get used to them. That's correct, of course. Muy bien, perfecto.
Muy bien.
Ah, muy bien, very good.
El padrino, tengo una Stratocaster del 79. Wow, that's super cool.
I'm sorry, I can't manage that language. I'm so sorry, I don't know. So Anne says, but guys, what are possessive pronouns? Then generally confundida. Don't worry, Anne. Stay with us.
No.
We will clarify that. Not in this video.
Not in this one.
But in the next one, but stay with us, okay?
No. So yeah. Just stick on this.
very good. So we have Diego misses the compliments, of course. I miss the compliments, and you should take the place of Janet. Falta leer los comentarios. Hey, CG Lau, hola CG Lau, ¿cómo estás? Tenemos algo aquí en Facebook, claro que sí, tenemos a Zacaría Rostami. Hi, hola de Libia, muchísimas gracias.
Wow, de Libia, muchos saludos.
Es Ahmed, es de Libia, muchísimas gracias por vernos, Ahmed, muchísimas gracias. So let's continue here, guys.
Y a todos, por favor, compartan este video. No se olviden de dar los pulgares arriba.
These guys are fed with likes, man. Mm-hmm. So please destroy that like button, okay?
And comment.
Every like you have is like hitting us. It's like giving us here like your approval for being here with you every Wednesday. So we truly appreciate it, guys.
And don't forget to write some comments, to say hello, just something.
Very good. Thank you. So, but let's continue.
Let's go.
Possessive adjectives, the tip number 3.
Yep.
And possessive adjectives are not usually used with body parts or articles of clothing. So the definite article, that is el, la, los, or las, is used instead.
Mm-hmm.
For example,
me duelen las piernas. Me duelen las piernas.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. My legs hurt. So we don't usually say me duelen mis piernas.
No, we don't say that.
Because if you are using, I mean, like that, dolerse, the reflexive.
You are using me duelen, right?
Me duelen.
So obviously that it's you talking about you. It's not like me duelen tus piernas. It's like, you don't say that. sounds cool though, but I wouldn't say me duelen tus piernas, no?
Me duele tu situación.
Tiene los ojos color café.
Tiene los ojos. Uh-huh. Color café.
Bueno, si tiene sus ojos.
No.
Color café.
Tiene sus ojos. No suena bien.
No.
So doesn't sound good.
Recuerden para body parts or articles of clothing, you use the possessive. The definite articles. El, la, los, or las. Let's go to the summary and the quiz, guys. So let's do very quickly the summary here. And the Spanish possessive adjectives are mi, tú, su, nuestro, nuestra. Uh-huh. Nuestros, nuestras, of course, and now the possessive adjectives come before the noun they refer to, so they are used before. So we don't say este es carro mi. No, you say este es mi carro. Right?
Okay.
You don't say oh esta es playera mi. No, you say esta es mi playera. Just as in English, okay?
Awesome.
They agree with what they describe. Therefore, They are not used depending on the subject, but rather on the possession, on the object. So remember, even if we say, Carlos perdió, and I use llaves, which is plural, I wouldn't say Carlos perdió su llaves.
Okay.
Or rather sus llaves, because the object is plural, right?
Oh.
Pretty nice. Now, to avoid confusion, it is sometimes clearer to use the él, de ella, de ellos, de usted.
Sí.
Or even de ustedes.
Ajá.
Very good. Now, the quiz, guys. Please participate with us in the chat down below. And how would you say these sentences in Spanish? The first one, your informal, not formal, but informal. Remember
your?
That your can be informal or formal.
Sí.
Your car. How do you say that? Your car. ¿Te gustaría un carro así, Efraín?
Sí.
¿Sí?
Sí.
You don't think about it like
para ir
not
cantando.
Even, not even one second.
Mi pa,
su.
Mi pa.
Very good.
Su. Okay, let's go.
Perfecto, vamos a ver, vamos a ver. Pa 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 pa. Yeah, look, Diego tan guapo, but my heart is all full of Efraín. Oh. Says Anne. Oh my God.
Corazón.
I smell wedding here. I smell wedding here.
Like,
very good. So
we are heading to Bosnia right now. Nos vamos a Bosnia.
So Rio Riley, tu carro, tu. Be careful here, Leah, because you're saying tu carro, tu coche. Okay, coche is also nice.
And
tu
your caro, car.
Your, and your
Spanish,
car. But in Spanish, Anne, how would that be? Tu carro.
Carro.
D. Phillips, carro tuyo. Oh, D. Phillips, stay
tuyo.
With us. Don't leave D. Phillips because we're going to tell you why that's not correct.
Tuyo.
Let's see. So this is tu carro or
tu
we
carro.
Have a synonym. Carro is in Mexican Spanish, but we also have auto or coche.
Ajá.
And that's it. Tu auto, tu coche, tu carro.
Sí, sí, sí.
Tu nave, güey.
Okay, tu nave, it's like a Mexican slang, nave.
How would you say our daughter? Because if you didn't know, we have one daughter. How do you say
oh.
our daughter?
Okay.
my small dog.
Oh,
my
really?
Dog.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, I've seen her.
Our daughter. How do you say our daughter? Pa-ra-pa-pa. I want to sing with you. Su, 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 su.
Mi pan, su, 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 su.
Very good.
Mi pan. Ñam, ñam, ñam.
Yeah, muy bien, Mari Flores, tu carro, eso estuvo muy bien también. Aniket, tú, el carro, be careful, just get rid of él, it's just tu carro. So we have nuestra hija.
Nuestra hija.
Anne says gasp in Spanish, because you told her, speaking in Spanish, she's like, gasp in Spanish.
Yeah, I got it.
Tu nave, güey. Yeah, Rio Riley got it.
Yeah.
Okay, nuestra hija, D. Phillips, mi hija, be careful here because it is our Efraín's and I, our daughter. Nuestra hija.
Muy fácil.
Nuestra hija.
Muy fácil.
This is very easy, man. Come on.
No. Next
nuestra
time.
Nuestra hija. Very good. Let's continue. ¿Cómo están los padres de Sandra? Padres están bien.
So,
padres están
bien.
Very good.
Ash Ketchup got a daughter. The one from Pokemon.
Really?
Nah. This is like fan art, I think.
Oh, this is fan art. Okay. I thought he actually had a daughter.
Efra, tienes una pequeña obsesión con TikTok.
Why? Is that in TikTok?
4K, 4K. Yeah.
That's in TikTok?
Yeah.
That's where you get your steps? From TikTok?
Well, maybe.
That song, Su 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 Su, is from TikTok?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? Okay, now I know. Wow, I didn't know that was a thing. I'm sorry, guys. I don't use social media. I'm sorry. I don't know what's
¿Cómo that. ¿Cómo le esta chica? What is her name? Like this, she... Yeah, the most liked TikTok.
Mari Flores,
TikTok.
Nuestra hija, that's correct. Mari Flores, Sus. Angélica Zarraga, ella... Be careful here, Angelica, because that's not a possessive adjective. Be careful there.
Mm-hmm.
So we have some answers already. Padres de Sandra. And, well,
okay,
I mean.
Yeah.
Sus padres, sus
padres están bien.
Be careful here, Umay, Calamay, tus. I kind of like his name, Umay Calamay.
Mm-hmm.
I like it.
It rhymes.
Yeah, it rhymes. So, tus. No, it's not tus, but rather it is
sus.
Sus padres están bien. Why? Because we're talking about los padres de Sandra.
She. Possessive adjective for her.
Her parents, right?
Her parents and
it is plural. That's why because
disagrees,
it is padres.
Disagrees with the
with
word
padres.
Uh-huh.
Good. The next one, your, the ustedes form, that is the formal, okay? House is very large.
Mm-hmm.
Your house is very large.
Yeah. Saludos a Seid Mara. Muchas gracias por enviar saludos.
Efra.
Ya hace mucho que no estabas.
I'm waiting for Sade Mara to write Diego.
keep waiting because he won't come.
Okay. I'm sure Sade Mara will write Diego and put a heart on it. Just wait for it.
Come on.
It will be?
How to
legend?
Wait for it. Dari.
Come on,
legendary.
Sademara, don't leave me like this. Diego with a heart. Come on, Sademara. I'm talking to you.
No, I think she can't. No.
Okay.
So, let's see.
I mean, like...
Yeah, your answers. We're waiting for your answers, guys, here. Do we have something on Facebook? Su casa.
Su casa.
Su casa, okay. It's very su large. Casa.
Okay, so we have su very casa. Large. Good. Thank you for participating here
but
with us.
How would
Flores.
You say it? How would you say it?
The full sentence.
The full sentence in Spanish. How do we say it?
Eso. Normally, eso.
Eso. Normally.
So, Matt's point, how do we say it in Spanish? Normally, we say eso. Mm-hmm. Very good. So, no one is participating here with us.
I feel bad, man.
Not Batman, but bad man.
Bad or bad?
I feel bad man.
Me siento mal.
Yeah, me siento mal.
¿Cuál es la diferencia entre sentir y sentirse?
Oh, well, I can explain that in exactly 44 seconds. But I won't do it in this lesson because we're talking about possessive attitudes.
I was like, whoa!
Oh, wow! No, I won't do it. Okay, well, no one is participating here with us, guys, so don't be shy, but we will give you now the answer, and the answer is...
Su casa es muy grande.
Su casa
es
muy
grande. Grande.
Perfecto, very good.
Okay, so, yeah. Get now your free PDF cheat sheets, and they are for free, as I told you, and you can find them in SpanishPod101.com. You just only need to get your free lifetime account. Okay, and it is for free. We are not asking for your money. That's the best part, where you can learn tons of new vocabulary every day. So increase your vocabulary set with us.
Mm-hmm.
Just a click away down there in the description, and it is up there. Thank you for everyone.
Oh, we're sorry. We couldn't update
We
couldn't update the comments. I don't know why,
sorry,
but I'm seeing here many people. Oh, you see, Sa de Mara wrote Diego. It means the heart. Oh, you see?
That's like
So, very good. So, su casa está grandote.
Grandota. Uh-huh.
Very good. Mi casa es su casa.
mi casa es su casa.
Very good. No, your comments are just late. Okay. I have just realized. Thank you.
Sí.
Su casa es muy grande. Very good, Mila. Muchísimas gracias. Oh, Diego beat Batman for Halloween.
Okay.
I might plan to become Hugh Hefner a zombie. You know? Hugh Hefner a zombie. So, please vote, guys. Should I wear a Batman costume or a Hugh Hefner?
I want
playboy?
To be Batman, man.
No,
I want to be Flash.
You can be Robin.
I love Flash.
You can be Robin. So, very good. muchas gracias. We just realized that it was actually the internet, but now we can see your comments. Thank you so much.
Please give him some compliments, Janet. He's desperate.
He's desperate.
I have aunt, so I don't need anything.
You don't need any other compliment. Okay. So, guys, the next topic that we have is this one, and that's the possessive pronouns in Spanish. We're going to check what's the difference,
uh-huh,
first of all, between the adjectives and the...
And the pronouns.
Possessive pronouns.
Yeah.
Stay with us, guys, because this lesson will blow your mind.
Yeah.
This is still kind of, not really, but kind of a beginner's lesson.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are intermediate, you might also find this lesson very useful, because we will also give you some tips for this. Okay.
And yeah, this is like a full course of possessive adjectives and pronouns, you know.
Exactly. So half an hour and then
free.
Half an hour.
For free.
So the only thing that you need
in
to do, guys, is just activate the channel notification so you know when our new live is going to be.
Because
which actually is on, you didn't put when, but it's basically next week.
I'm sorry.
Same time, same hour.
Next week.
Same everything.
Yeah.
Maybe
but
a different background.
Different background. I'm going to put something like Halloween.
Related to Día de Muertos.
Or Día de Muertos. I don't know yet.
Closer. So, muchísimas gracias a todos. Muchas gracias. Matt Point, gracias por tu ayuda. Muchas gracias a ti. Very good. ¿Te gusta la parca? Dice Sean Witt.
Matt Points, you guys are friends? No, we're not. I hate him.
No, we're not friends. We are actually a couple in problems. In crisis. Ya. Gracias por la lección, Cody. No, Cody, gracias a ti por estar con nosotros. Muchísimas gracias.
MGMT.
Oh, D. Phillips. He gave us $5. D. Phillips, this is the first time ever that someone gave us some dollars. So, thank you so much, D. Phillips, for the $5. We truly appreciate it.
It is the first time.
You're the first one, and we just want to say your name like 5 times because one is
Thank you, D. Phillips. A mezcal for you.
This is a this is truly a mezcal.
This is a mezcal.
Should we drink this, man?
No, it's too strong.
No,
okay. Not yet. Okay. Not tonight.
Well, thank you. Muchísimas gracias. Thank you. So much drama, and yes, I do agree, Janet. She's such a dramatic girl, but we still love her, right? Muchas gracias, chicos, y nos vemos en la siguiente lección.
Muy bien, muchas saludos a Mike Amar, Japanese Learning with Fun, a AG The Lighter,
Jennifer Hunt, muchas gracias, y nos vemos. Mike
Punch, gracias otra vez
a Max Points, jaja, couples, yeah, we're couples. A couple in crisis.
Gracias a D. Phillips, y muchas gracias a Mary Flores, Joy Pedrajas, Very Useful, Aniket, Sonja, espera, wait, Angelica Saraga, who says I'm learning from you. Okay, that's it, thank you.